lovely readers, how are you? Welcome back to my channel Read with Megha. How are you all doing? Happy Sunday and happy weekend to all of you. I hope you are reading a lot of books, and if you haven't picked a book this weekend, this is the right time to chill back and relax and pick a perfect book for your weekend. And moreover, to all my Indian viewers, happy Independence Day to all of you. Today I have the perfect book for the Independence Day, and that is none other than this book, Train to Pakistan by author Khushwant Singh. This book is based on independence, and I have read this book long back in 2019. I'm planning to read this today as well on the occasion of Independence Day. And here's the book. For all of those who don't know what this book is about the partition of India and Pakistan in the year of 1947, and we have Jugat Singh as our protagonist. Though he's a gangster of the village, but the whole story is based on him and the other lives that were affected due to partition in that year. As far as I remember, these lives faced a very drastic end and rest. I'll tell you after reading this once more. And let's jump to the next book in the list. So the next book in the list is this, The Canvas of Words by author Monica Bharti. It's a very short read. I have already read this book a few days back. This is an amalgamation of 50 poems and 50 micro-poetries. Each and every poetry and each and every piece of art depicts a human emotion, and that emotions are precisely based on the authoress lives herself. And few of the poems that I really enjoyed reading were The Tainted Heart, The Brand New Day, and Never Stop. And the last was Forbidden Fruit. It was indeed a pleasure reading these poetries and connect through the author's heart. I hope you also enjoy this read. Now let's talk about the next read of the list, which just arrived when I was beginning the shoot of this video. That is this. This is how the book looks like. It is The Urban Chronicles Part 2 by author Nita Bajoria. And to my surprise, it is a graphic novel, okay? I haven't read any graphic novel in ages. I remember reading few in my childhood, and after that I haven't read any. So soon I'll be sharing the experience of if I relive my childhood memories of reading the graphic book or not. So let's hop up to the next book in the series or the list, today's list. And that is this beauty, Bloom. This is how the book looks like. Bloom, a poetic collection by authoress Sneha Narayanan. The book is divided into three major parts basically. The first one is body positivity and self-acceptance. The part two is positive thoughts and happiness. The next one is Caged Butterfly, the awakening. The book talks about the journey of healing, body positivity, self-acceptance, and rising above the validation of this judgmental world, which all of us once or multiple times have faced in our lives, okay? There is a small note by the authoress herself for all of us, is that be grateful for who you are and love yourself fiercely. You and nobody can take that away. such a great line, no? Even I loved it. We'll be looking forward to read this and will share my experience about reading this book, and will let you know all that if this book ever impacted my life or brought some positive change in my inner self. So these were my remaining August reads, these four books. I hope you loved listening about them. Do let me know in the comment section which books excited you most, and also comment your monthly TBR or what are you reading this August. I'll be glad to hear new suggestions from you. Till then, a very happy Sunday and a very happy Independence Day to all of you. Keep reading, keep growing. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, comment and subscribe to Read with Megha. And I will meet you guys on the next Sunday with a brand new video. Till then, take care. Bye. Thanks for watching.